Brian Plum. The months and years of the war dragged slowly on. Sunday after Sunday, the faithful would gather to pray for peace. Mothers and fathers would pray for young soldiers and face their worst fears with faith in God, seeking encouragement from their brothers and sisters in Christ. By November 1944, the Allies had gained ground in France and Belgium, and our leaders knew the war, though, was far from over.
And daughters have gone off to war. A couple of years ago, my son was here with us at Christmas time. If you remember, he and another young lady read the scripture and lit the Advent candle. Now, he's in Europe on the Western Front. I received this letter from him this week. Dear Mom, sorry for not writing for several weeks, but we've been on the move. Although most everybody thinks the enemy is hightailing at home, I've got this funny feeling that something big is about to happen. I don't think Hitler is ready to give up yet. We've set up camp somewhere in northern France, near Belgium. Now we're waiting for orders. It's very cold here, but we try to keep warm as best we can. Tell everyone I miss them and love them. Christmas will be here in a few weeks. It just won't be the same so far from home. Please pray that this war ends soon. I've come to realize more there's no place like home, the good old USA. I keep thinking of that one Christmas carol. While shepherds watch their flocks, there's a verse that says, "Fear not." He said, "For mighty dread had seized their troubled mind." It's hard not to live in fear on the battlefront, but I keep holding fast to the good tidings of the birth of a Savior. Keep me in your prayers, your son James. Could we please stand and sing while shepherds watch their flocks and remember that God is watching over us and those brave sons and daughters who are in harm's way around the world.
Yeah.
light went out over darkness, when good went out over evil. While the battles raged in Europe and in the Pacific, people of faith waged a spiritual battle against the forces of evil. They prayed, they hoped, and they trusted.
A few days ago, I received a letter from the government stating that my son was missing in action. Christmas is in 2 weeks, and I'm praying for a miracle. The army doesn't know where he is, but God knows. I remember the day he was born. His father and I made that desperate journey to the hospital. It was a day of great suffering, but great joy. This morning, Pastor asked me to read the New Testament scripture lesson. It's a familiar passage from Luke. Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 7. It's about a long and dangerous journey Joseph and Mary made. They made it to Nazareth, or from Nazareth to Bethlehem. But God watched over them, and God watches over all of our sons and daughters. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them. You may remain seated as we sing Away in the Manger.
Those who are sick, who are battling some physical ailment, we pray. May your healing power touch their lives. Lord, we especially ask that you would be with those who are feeling low at this time of year. Surround them with people who encourage them and lift their hearts. May the light of Christ light up their lives. And finally, Lord, we ask you to be with those who are sacrificing for our freedom in the past and today. Be with those whose lives are on the line right now to protect us. May they draw near to you and experience the peace that surpasses human understanding. Bring them safely home to their families. May this world of darkness experience the light and the peace of Christ. And now we pray together the prayer that the Son of God taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debts. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. On Christmas Eve, 1944, so many people were praying that the light and peace of Christ would overpower the darkness that enveloped the world. On that holy night 2,000 years ago, that hope arrived in the form of a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes. Holly will now come and sing for